How long have we been talking about drag and drop on Hubitat dashboards?
Probably since I met you a couple years
Probably
ago. Oh my
since we've
gosh.
known each other, right?
Yeah.
Can you see my screen?
I can see your screen. My gosh.
About that?
That's amazing.
You want to know how I do it?
Yeah.
Stay tuned.
Oh, shit.
Having the ability to drag and drop on Hubitat dashboards is a long-awaited feature. Unfortunately, we had to look to the community and not the brains of Hubitat themselves to come up with a solution. What we're about to walk through is a community app, which means it is not supported by Hubitat, so do not reach out to Hubitat support. I also can't guarantee that this feature will remain working for the life of your hub, because that's really out of the community's and our hands. The good news is that it does work today, and it is liberating. You're going to want to follow these steps closely. Omitting even one step will result in it not working. And with that, let's get into it. And just as a baseline, our hub is at 2.3.5.152. That's where I'm currently updated to, so I know it's working as of this version. Okay, so the first thing we're going to need to do is go over to the Hubitat Package Manager. And if you don't have Hubitat Package Manager installed, there's another video that shows you how to do that. I suggest you go get Hubitat Package Manager installed first, and then come back here and we'll get you going with drag and drop. Okay, so once we're in Hubitat Package Manager, we are going to want to do an install, and let's do a search by keywords. And we are looking for smartly inject. I don't name these things, but that is what it's called. So you're looking for smartly inject by Markus. We're going to select that. Ready to install. Let's do a next. And click that next button again. And the package is successfully installed. We can click next. And if we come down to look at view apps and drivers, we'll be able to see there it is. Okay, all done with that. Quick, easy, and painless. Okay, so the next thing we're going to want to do is we're going to want to come up and create a virtual device. Add device right here, virtual. Now the device name will be smartly, and I want to give it a device label of drag and drop. Now we come over to our type of device, and we're going to go all the way down to the bottom where our customs are, and we have a smartly inject device. Room is not going to matter. Save that device. Now, on some versions, it says loading layout. Don't worry about that. You're just going to want a backspace out of that. Nothing's wrong with it. It's still there. It still works. And now we're going to go back to apps, and you're going to want to pick a dashboard. I suggest that you use a dashboard that's a test dashboard. Don't try this the first time on a dashboard that you're very proud of and that you love and that your family uses. That would be a bad idea. So what I'm going to do is first is I'm going to create me a couple of test dashboards. There's going to be two ways I'm going to show you how to do this. So I'm going to need one dashboard for each ways. So we're going to create our first dashboard, which is drag and drop test one. And let's throw some devices on there. The first device you want to make sure you have on there is that drag and drop virtual device. And I'm just going to throw some other devices on there for fun. Here we go. Done with that. Then we've got drag and drop two. And we're going to do the same thing to drag and drop test two. We want that drag and drop. That's the most important one on there. And then we're going to add our virtual devices. Save that. Now I've got two dashboards I can work with. And yes, you're going to need to add that drag and drop device to each one of the dashboards that you want to have this capability on. But trust me, it is way faster than reorganize large and complex dashboards without the drag and drop capability. Now, as I said, there's going to be two options. Option one is a lot easier, but it's going to give you some pre-formatted dashboards, and those styles, you may like them and you may not. Option two allows you to have the basic dashboard themes or styles, and you have full control over them. It's a little bit more complicated, but not much. If you're looking for option two, there's a timestamp right here. Okay, so for option one, we are going to go over to our dashboards, and we're looking for drag and drop test one. And let's go ahead and just say autofill everything for us. So here's all of the devices that I added spread along. Everything is good to go. First thing we're going to want to do is come up and click that gear icon. Click on advanced. Now this is called JSON code. If you're already familiar with it, you understand what this is. But this is what tells that dashboard how it's configured. Now we're going to want to grab a notepad or whatever type of text editor you have. Just click into the JSON, do a control or select all, do a copy, control C or command C, go over to your text pad and copy that in. This is your original version of the JSON. So if anything happens and we decide that we want to revert back, we have a copy of this. So let's go in and do a file save. And I'm going to set that aside for a moment. Next up, there's a link below to the EZEEK formatter website. You're going to want to go to the EZEEK website and copy and paste that link. And you can also now, we can grab our JSON code from our text editor. And we're going to paste it out into the EZEEK website. And now you can pick your theme. So you get a little glimpse of what that theme is in the background. Every time you change this, it's going to change it around for you. But that'll be the background of your dashboard. Now, once you decide that you have a dashboard theme that you like, click Update. And then copy to clipboard. It's copied. We'll go back. Again, make sure this is all selected. And we're going to paste. And now it looks way more complicated than it did before. Come down and do a save JSON layout. Hit the X. And now you see all of your buttons on your dashboards have been resized and you have that background theme. Now we still don't have drag and drop. We've got to do one more thing. Let's go up here to this plus button. And we'll go down and we'll look at our drag and drop, select that, and you see the attribute under pick a template, and under pick an attribute, you're going to want to select JavaScript. Add that tile, and you'll see it pop up, and then it disappeared, and there we go. So now you have that tile appeared and then went away, but you see now you have this paw and this check mark. Click the paw, and now we're dragging and dropping. You can also do some resizing. And it'll bump other things out of the way. It's pretty cool. And then once you're happy with the layout, save. Click the paw again, and you're back to normal. And everything's off and running. So that's method one. And the next method we're going to do is going to be without the theme. It's going to preserve your original theme. So if we go back over here and we look at our drag and drop test two, again, let's just add everything. So it should look very similar to what it did before. It'll preserve this theme, but we have to do things a little bit more manually. We don't have that automated tool to put that code in for us. So buckle up, let's go for a ride. So to get started on option two, what we're going to want to do is again, come over to the gear icon, go into advanced, and here's that same JSON code. It'll be a little bit different. This is dashboard two. Select it all, copy it all, and I'm going to put it into a notepad. I'm going to save that. And then I'm going to have a second notepad, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to paste it into a second notepad. Now, if you can see this, you'll see one is titled original and the other one is titled new. So I can put the original aside. Hopefully I won't need that. That's my backup of my dashboard. Now from here, instead of going down to the link for the EZEEK formatter, we're going to go to a link. There's a description, a link in the description below to, it says link to raw JSON. And we're going to want to go to that website. When you go to that website, you'll see this code here. You should have four lines, opening brace, closing brace, we're going to want to get lines 2, 3, and 4. Try not to get the first brace there. If you get it, it's not too bad. Well, I'll show you how to fix that. We're going to want to copy this, and we're going to come back to Dashboard Test 2 New. Go all the way to the bottom. And what you have on the bottom may be different than mine. It's going to be depending on your dashboard, but just go all the way to the bottom and you should have, the last line would have no comma. Every line before that's going to have a comma, except for the last line. You should have no comma and then a brace. What we're going to do is we're going to add one more comma, go to a new line, and we're going to paste in all that code. Now, because we grabbed that last brace also, and we did that to make sure we got the end of line 3 from that other website, we're just gonna hit delete a couple of times, and we're gonna take out that last brace, okay? Now, if you grabbed line 1 and you brought that brace in, here's our icon size 42 with that comma, just come over. If there's no brace here, you didn't get it. If there is a brace here, so say it came in like that, you're just going to want to take that brace out. Now be careful that you're not taking out other braces. Those are needed. Just if it's from between your last line and the first line you pasted in, make sure there's no brace there. Once you get that pasted in, we're going to select it and copy it. We're going to go back to our dashboard and we're going to paste it. Save this JSON layout. Layout saved, no errors. We're going to exit. And then once again, we're going to come over and we're going to find that drag and drop attribute. Pick an attribute is going to be JavaScript. Add tile. Okay, and again, as soon as we added that tile, you'll see the paw and the check mark appear. Now, because we're not using the EZEEK style, we are going to have this widget here. So if you don't like that, we can just get it off the screen. We can make it go lower. It's a side effect of not using their tile, but it does nothing to affect how your dashboard works. And now that we have everything set up, click the paw, and we are dragging and dropping, just like your mother said you could do. Click save, click the paw, and we're done. And now everything just works normally. If you want to add more devices, you can add more devices. Everything works as it should. You can still come in here and do all of your standard dashboard template-y stuff and make it look exactly the way you want it to. Like how it pushes things out of the way. And that's pretty much it. That's how you get drag and drop onto your Hubitat dashboards. Hope you found this video useful. Thanks for hanging out with me. I know I've been loving this. It's saving me a lot of time. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to click like, and don't forget to spank that bell icon if you're into that sort of thing. Until next time, cheers. And don't forget to join our live event on YouTube Thursday, August 24th, 2023 at 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Pacific. We'll have a big channel announcement that you won't want to miss. If you happen to be watching this video after the broadcast, don't worry, there's a link in the description below.